The next topic, if I refer by the textbook of Thompson, it's going to be chapter 4. Okay, now this going to be the topic for us, the harmonic vibration or we start to study for voice vibration. Before that, we just study about vibration only. Okay, let's to give you the idea for this one of voice harmonic. Okay, I can consider this basic one degree of signal system. Okay, look like this one. As you have learned, it can be equivalent as K can be equivalent spin. Okay, whenever we reduce the system to this one, okay, it can be just simple and KC system. Okay, and now for the force. Okay, a force in this case means to control. To control the motion is not meaning as force in the time or on the way. In this case, a force system for this one is the configuration of the force step or the force excitation system. Okay, having the force as the excitation of the input function of the system. Okay, by harmonic function, it can be this one. Sine omega t cosine these are the four forms of the forcing function for the force excitation system. Okay, just to remind you, we also have this type of system. I call it as the displacement excitation system. In this case, we would like to observe the vibration at the mass, but in this case, what is the excitation? So, in this case, it's going to be the same as y omega and so on. In this case, it's going to be y sine omega t cosine. Okay, so in this case, from whatever the harmonic vibration, you can see that in this case, we know what is given F for the excitation amplitude. F in Newton or Y, capital Y in meter in this measurement. So this is going to be the excitation amplitude going to be given by the condition of this one. Another one, we have omega, the same, this is going to be as the excitation frequency. Okay, the excitation is also known as the input function. Or sometimes can be the amplitude. Amplitude plus amplitude displacement and so on. Okay, vibration are reduced acceleration, but sometimes we also refer to as the input. So these are the two known conditions because sine and cosine are characterized by the frequency omega and when the attitude, much attitude is currently. Okay, next, if I view the system as a block diagram, okay, we have an NKC system. Okay, we have the excitation, okay, F of T as the force, or we can have the displacement excitation by of T. Okay, the main point is this one, the base from X of T. As we solve for the free vibration. Okay, this response we are interested only for this case as the steady state response. Don't forget that X is the displacement. So sometimes we can call this one as the steady state displacement response to power it through. So in this case, we can put this one as X sub SS. So this is going to be the function that we would like to find for this topic. So this is the next one. Okay, before I go into mathematics for solving this one, first, I might give you the basic idea is that if start with the equation of motion, okay, because I have Fx dot plus Cx dot plus Kn. Okay, for the basic system, I will use this one first. Okay, with the input function, F of T equal to sine function. Okay, that's going to be the most basic one. Or I can write in the parameter or characteristic of the second order system to say that omega of n n plus plus omega of n square n equal to this one divided by n F sine omega t. That's going to be function of equation to know it exactly or this particular function into this excitation of the system. Okay, next to find the rest part, which I would like to say this one first as the total rest part x of t. Okay, the left side x of t. Okay, as we have the Coulomb function, okay, we can have this function x sub c of t for the complementary. I'm not going to rewrite that one. Okay, and then the second one going to be for sub p of the particular solution. Okay, I will give you the idea for the total response x of t. Okay, complementary depends on the damping ratio. It comes with the system, with the damping ratio and natural frequency. So this one, I just maybe summarize just what you have, just have for the exam this morning. Okay, just to remind you, we're gonna have something like a cosine omega sub nt plus b sine omega sub nt. Okay, the next one, E to the minus theta omega sub n t A cosine omega sub t t to b sine omega sub t t. Okay, the next one, A plus b t E to the minus omega sub n t. Actually, this one minus theta, but theta equal to 1, so it's going to be minus omega sub n t. The last one, A e r sub 1t plus b e r sub 2t. I'm not going to be writing the value of the root of the characteristic equation. Okay, I'll just write it that way. Okay, that's going to be complementary solution. Okay, just to remind you, okay, this first line going to be for no dam. Okay, this is for under dam. Okay, this critically dam. Okay, and the last one for over dam. Okay, so complementary depends on the dynamic ratio of the system. Okay, next particular solution. Okay, as in Coulomb friction, we have concentric, okay, on the right side. Okay, this one, the right side of this non-homogeneous differential equation is time function. So this particular function got to be harmonic function, which means that it's going to be the combination of both sine and cosine, which can be written this one as a cosine omega t plus b sine omega t. And I also say this is going to be a sub t, b sub t for particular part. And the thing to point out, this is not going to be that much different in color. Omega, okay, this is going to be the same as this one, or it is the excitation frequency. Okay, this is going to be 4. Okay, so this is going to be S total response. Total response for me is going to be start from time greater than equal to 0. Or in this case, if I just do it, the recording of this total response. Okay, it's gonna start x of t at time equal to 0. It has no motion or it is in equilibrium. Okay, and then when you start, depend on the dynamic ratio of your system. So if I just say it's gonna be under bit of under that, or a bit of some under that. Okay, so this is f sub c of t for theta less than 1. Okay, and the particular solution, okay, going to be this function as our superposition to the overall function. It's going to be start by this one. It's going to be same as n of t. Okay, this start at 0. Or I may say, let's say, this orange curve overall from the start up to right here. Okay, that's going to be this function x of t according to function 4 depend on the dynamic ratio. Okay, when you observe for this one, okay, as I told you, at the beginning, no motion, it is as equilibrium. It's just similar to an machine that we not operate on, it is at our return down. Okay, And then after this time, okay, now we just switch on, turn it down. Okay, everything now working, and time it goes to zero. So this is called the total response. Okay, you can observe there's going to be some uneven motion, something like this one. The peak from one period to another period is not constant. It just change every period. And at this period of time, okay, we can call this as the transient. Gonna be up in the transient period or transient portion of the system. Okay, and then it's up to some period of time. Okay, I might take this color. Okay, up to this point, which indicates the delta T for this one, a lot greater than zero, which means that the transient die out. And now we get only for this repeated harmonic function, or it becomes infinite. Portion of what we call as the steady state portion of period. Okay, so in this case, I'm going to renumber the time instead of at the start of the system when we turn it on. This after we turn it on for a long period of time, start the new time. And this is going to be what we call as the steady state portion, S of SS of C. So as you might have seen for this one, for the complementary, okay, we have some damp, negative damp, that time that goes to infinity, it becomes zero. Okay, so the remaining term in this case is just only reduced to x sub e of the complementary. So what we are interested for this topic right now is after this portion, or under the steady state period. And then we're going to have this constant amplitude of the response as well as for this one. Okay, in this case, it could be the period T equal to pi over omega. Don't forget to make up the input frequency. Actually, for this one, it's the same even for during the transient portion, okay, and that's going to be the period. Small frequency, small period for the response. Okay, and I'm going to replace the axis. So we have two axis. The blue one, let's start from the beginning. The purple one is the, okay, and it time after we have turned it down for a long period of time or when it becomes steady. Okay, and this one start at time equal to 1, time equal to 0, represent time a lot greater than 0 at this one. Okay, while we are interested only in transient, even though you can see that the peak of the vibration a lot higher during the transient. Okay, because in this case, this just represents something like an electrical motor or the electrical pump that we are using for pumping the water or compressor in the air condition. In this case, you can see that when we turn it on, or when the air condition is on. Okay, you might have heard some mechanical noise that could be during this transient. After that, that noise is going to be died out, and then you get very low noise from when it operates in this range. Okay, which means that for most of the time, when we are using the room with that air condition. Okay, for million of 2 hours, 3 hours for the whole day. That could be the operating condition that we would like to reduce the noise or vibration during that period. So that is why we are investing at this period. Not this one. This one could be the next topic. Okay, for that soon. So this is the condition that why we interesting in service there. Okay, that's gonna be the introduction. Okay, about the steady state harmonic vibration. Okay, the portion of time that we are interesting. Okay, next, I think I continue for this one.